What's up, everybody? Back with another video from Kyiv, Ukraine, and today I have an extra special video because not only are we at one of my favorite places in the entire city, but as you can tell by the title, I also have a new toy to play with, but we'll get to that in just a little bit. Located behind me is the gorgeous St. Andrew's Cathedral, which sits atop of St. Andrew's Descent. I apologize for the change in scenery, but I kept getting chased out of the way by cars trying to get up and down the street, so I'll go ahead and finish this intro and then we'll get back down there and get a closer look at the church and the descent itself. So a little history on the church. The church was built between 1747 and 1754, and the design was by the Italian architect Baratelli. So even 200 years later, you can tell that the church itself is just an extremely impressive structure. But can you imagine trying to build this by hand in 18th century construction tools? That just had to be a massive undertaking that, like I said, 200 years later is still quite impressive. Now, the church itself is named after St. Andrew Rus, which is a throwback to the old Kievan Rus Empire, which I spoke about in one of my other videos. And the story goes, St. Andrew crossed the from one side of the river to the other here, and on top of this hill where the church sits now, he erected a cross. And so he made a proclamation at that time that this sparsely populated area would one day be a great city. And, you know, today it's the city of Kyiv, 3.4 million people. Now, something unique about this particular church is it doesn't have any bells, because when it was constructed, the superstition was the noise from the bells would cause a flooding of the lower city. This church is also one of four pieces of architecture throughout Ukraine that is placed on the list of mankind treasures of five continents by the World Society. Throughout the years, pieces of its architecture, ornamented architecture on the outside, has been found laying around in the surrounding areas, which gives the local authorities some concern and has really stepped up restoration. In fact, I've been visiting Kyiv for 4 years, so since 2016, and I have yet to be inside because restoration continues. So I know you want to see inside, so do I. Eventually, someday, maybe we both will. So that's about it for now. For the intro, I'm going to go down. We're going to get a closer look at the church, closer look at Andrew's Descent, and then I'll give you a little bit of background on Andrew's Descent, and then we'll see what it looks like from above. So see you in just a second. St. Andrew's Descent, or Andriski Uzis, is an area that connects the old city to the lower district of Podil. This is a favorite area of Kyiv among the tourists, as it's normally lined with street vendors, artisans, restaurants, cafes. But as you can see, the streets are mostly bare still because of quarantine. However, some of the vendors have started setting back up, so it's a sign that life is returning to normal. The street is made, as you can see, with cobblestones inlaid by hand. It's almost 730 meters long, which is about 2,400 feet for you people across the ocean to the west. And as the church I mentioned earlier was part of the National Historic Reserve of the Sofia of Kyiv, the street itself is part of the Kyiv City Reserve, which is called Ancient Kyiv. So we'll walk down through here, get a little look at it, and then we'll see what it looks like from above as well. Thank you. I just walked all the way down Andrew's Descent, and trust me, you don't want to walk up that thing. So Ubers and Bolts are really cheap throughout Kyiv, under $2 to $3 most places you want to take in the city. So I would suggest, if you're going to visit Andrew's Descent and church, take a Bolt or an Uber up to the top and then walk down the descent. You'll thank me for that later. And at the bottom of the descent on the left, you will see my favorite mural in Kyiv. It's entitled Renaissance by the artist Seth Globe Painter and a Ukrainian artist named Kislo. So that's going to do it for my video today. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.